Okay. I will continue to speak about English, and I think it's what it's helpful, it's useful to speak about my lessons that I get from the internet and just describe to myself what I learn and how I understand it. For example, now I just finished one lesson reading a book, Murphy's book, and I write something, and it was easy, way easy, but it's useful information because I have a lot of mistakes with this topic, and sometimes I even don't understand that I'm doing these mistakes. But now, just after watching this, after learning this lesson, I began to understand it better, and now I need to practice this this syntaxes. Okay, the thing that I learned. Okay, after enjoy my mind. It's about using a verb. It's about using two verbs when they are stand together one after another. Yesterday I get, or maybe the day before yesterday, when I learned this, I work with the material when you should use infinite form after verb. For example, after enjoy, mind, and suggest, we use inch. I enjoy playing. You suggest going there. Would you mind speaking English? Here are some more verbs that are followed by inch. Stop, delay, fancy, consider, admit, miss, involve, finish, postpone, imagine, avoid, deny, yeah, risk, practice, give up, put off, carry on, keep on. It's very stupid. Yeah, it doesn't work in such a way, because it was something I learned yesterday, and it seems to me very, very, stop to use a lot of time the word very. Okay, today I learned about verb plus two, and also I wrote I just rewrote everything that I read, and now I just read it, at least I try to read it. If these verbs are followed by another verb, the structure is usually verb plus two. Offer, fail, decide, hope, learn, deserve, forget, promise, threaten, agree, refuse, plan, arrange, aim, effort, attempt, manage. It was late, so we decided to take a taxi home. Simon was in a difficult situation, so I agreed to lend him some money. How old were you when you learned to drive? I waved to Karen, but failed to attract her attention. Note these examples with the negative not to. We decided not to go out because of the weather. I promised not to be late. With many verbs, you cannot normally use to. I enjoy dancing. Jan suggested going to the cinema. Are you thinking of buying a car? Think and suggest dancing or enjoy. There is also a continuous infinitive. To be doing, I pretended to be reading the book, and a perfect infinitive. You seem to have lost weight. Oh, it's stupid exercise. It's very stupid. When I just trying to read about it or to repeat something that I've wrote, is completely unsuitable. Why? Because I just read it and it doesn't work. In order to do it better, in order to explain it better to myself, I just need to repeat this stuff in my mind, and I need to use my own words to explain how to use correctly these grammar structures. And it's also very easy. I can say, okay, there are two verbs. For example, the verb think and the verb think, speak. Yeah, I think to speak. No, okay, it's a little bit stupid. Let's use other example. The verb stop and the verb do. Yeah, and if I should to speak, I stop do. I need to use I stop doing. I can't. I can of course say I stop to do, but it doesn't suitable. And I need to use I stop doing. But if there are such verb as hope, for example, I should say I hope to get. For example, I can say I hope getting. Yeah, and it's something I can really use it, but it doesn't sound naturally. And if I learn to use it properly, I will remember it better. But of course, for this I should practice more. And I should write, I should speak about it, and follow and observe my speech and make a correction to myself. Okay, the time is gone and I will speak about it later or maybe not.